In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use the accept language header to change the language which your Rails app responds with. I'm also going to show you how you can override that by changing the URL a little bit. Before I start, please remember to smash the subscribe button and give me a like. It helps me so much. Okay, let's jump into the video. I'm going to start off by showing you how the T method works in Rails, and that means translate. So if I was to do T and body text, then reload this page, it'll output the word body text. However, if I was to then inspect this, I get a span which says, hey, this translation is missing, here's the key for it. So what this wants us to do is to go to our locale file, which is located in config locales. In this case, I put it in en.yml, and we have to kind of complete this key. So if we go en landing, which we have here, the index, and we do body text, we can set it to say whatever we want. So we could be like, hello, body. And it's just updated. So how do we change that language we're showing? The way to do that is by changing the locale. And if we go to the landing controller quickly, I can show this to you. Let's say DE. So that'll be D for German. And you'll notice it's just fallen back to English. So what's happening here? Well, if we go to our locale file and we look at the German, we'll notice that no key has been added. So let's kind of copy the body text here. And let's just write the word in German. There we go, it's just updated. So we now can switch between the English language and German. So we need a way for the user to be able to change this locale. We're going to start off by using a parameter. So we're going to use params, we're going to just do locale, and we're going to have a fallback of the item default locale. So if I was to refresh this now, okay, it's just fallen back to English. And if we do locale equals DE, it's now returning German. So this URL isn't that nice. It'd be nice if we could just pass it into the URL, like as a directory. So let's do that. So the way we can do this is by adding a scope and being something like this. So a scope, everything within this block has a locale parameter. And we're just going to do get forward slash to, and we're going to route every request to that root index. So let's have a look how that looks. Yeah. Okay, we get the English. Get the German. That's pretty cool. What if someone was this kind of playing around with the URL and typed in French? Okay. So it would return an invalid locale error. This is fine. But it'd be kind of nice if we could restrict that and return a 404 because we haven't set up the app to like kind of handle that. So what we'll do is we'll do en or de. I think that is how you write that. So you make a regular expression for this particular parameter and it has to be en or de. Okay, that worked. That works as well. Super nice. Really good. That URL is a fine approach, but what's quite interesting, if we go to this network tab and we have a look at the HTTP request, we'll notice that my browser is actually sending a HTTP header called accept language. And this is the one we should really be using by default. So if we go to here, right now it's falling back to English, but it's not using the English. So let's set that up. So the first thing I'm going to do is do bundle add rack contrib. So this is a a gem where it just has a few little rack kind of classes in there, and they kind of fit into your middleware. And we're going to restart Rails in a second. So next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go to a locale file. I've set up an initializer called locale, and we're going to set two things in here. First thing we're going to do is we're going to use this thing called rack locale, and this is going to say, look at that HTTP header, and it's going to go, right, this user, they want English, they've requested that, let's set that as the locale, which is quite good. And I'm also going to go into here, and we're going to add en-db, which is the locale I actually am sending as a header. And we're going to restart Rails. Okay, let's see what this does. So right now it doesn't do too much. Let's have a look at this. So right now we're falling back to the default locale. So what if I was to say, just use this locale? Okay, there we go. Howdy, buddy. In British English, that's pretty good. So one thing we should probably consider now is refactoring this a little bit, because it only will change the locale on the one action. We want it to do it everywhere. So let's open up our action application controller even. And we're going to make a method called switch locale. Oops. And we're going to use this method called i18 with locale and an action. And I'm going to do action there as well. So we're going to run this around our action. So this will mean at the start of a request, we will like change the locale, and then it will revert back to its default once it's complete. This way, it's a lot more thread safe. So let's go around action, switch locale, and I'm just going to do raise locale here. What? No, I'm just going to do raise foobar. I just want to see what this does quickly. Okay, so you can see it's running now. Can kind of see where it's kind of kicked off. Yeah, it's gone to run all the process action, all that jazz, which is good. So let's now take this here, and we're going to say, okay, if we have a locale, use that. Otherwise, use the one we've been given by our rack gem, which is good. I'm just going to also save this. Let's see how that works. Okay, that's quite cool. And if we go to D, nice. Let's add some forms and then jazz them up with a bit of i18n. So I'm going to go to the roots, and I've already set up a resource called pets. So if I go to here, go pets, I get something. So right now, this hasn't actually been translated at all. So even though we are passing a German language in, so let's get a really nice quick win. We're going to go to the terminal. We're going to do bundle add rails i18n. And this is a gem where it's all of the common Rails kind of things just translated. Oh, Rails restart. Not restarted. Okay, that's restarting over here. Okay. You can now see this is all changed, and that is German. And then this is German, which is really cool. And let's kind of up it a bit more. Let's change these labels around here. Like, that'll be quite nice. So for this one, we're going to do bundle add, and I'm going to do i18n debug and group development like this. So this is going to add the i18n debug gem to our development environment. And this is going to allow us to see what keys are coming up. So if I do Rails restart, and then open another terminal now and do tails. When we refresh that form, we're going to get a bunch of keys appear into here. So send. Okay, you can see it's now added a bunch of lines with the prefix of item debug. And these are the actual keys which are being looked up on the page, which is really handy for debugging. So let's change this name here. So we know it's an attribute and we know it's going to be in German, so it's probably this one here. The active record attributes pet name. So we're going to go to de.yml and we're going to again just change all the dots to be colons and German name. Pretty good. Let's try this again. There we go. And what's cool here is it's also updated the error message. So you didn't actually have to do too much work there. You're probably wondering why this bit here hasn't been translated. And that's because if you go to the pet form, the Rails scaffolding hasn't actually put the translation in for that. But we can come back and sort that another day. One other thing I really want to show you, and that is how Rails formats dates for you with ITNN. So if I go back to that index.html, I'll probably go back to it here as well. So let's quickly add some line breaks. And we do time.zone.now. So that's pretty cool. That's how you'd expect Rails to store stuff. If you were to chuck the localization, or the L helper in, it will format it to be localized. But if I change it to DE, it's now showing it in the German style. We can do something a little bit cooler with that. If we did format long, again, that's the exact same format there, but a little bit more tidied up. And if we did short, it'll show us the shorthand. We could do slash D to that as well, and it will do the same thing. That's super nice. That is the end of this video. I'm hoping you found that useful and enjoyable. I am MikeRogers0 on Twitter. If you have any questions, feel free to send me a message or drop a little comment underneath this video. Thank you for watching, and I will catch you next time.